Hello everyone, welcome back. There is a new mod update and this time is DerreTech. For those who don't know, it is a shipbuilding mod that gives you new modules across different categories, structural, graph drives, landing gear, etc, etc. It is a pretty cool mod. I've been using it for a while already and there's been a new update just recently with a lot of changes, some new additions, and I want to give you a tour and show you everything that is new. There is one particular change that I'm not a big fan of. I'm gonna go over that as well. But anyway, let's get started with the first one. DerreTech now has its own headquarters. This is brand new. It is located in the system of Arcturus. I think I am pronouncing that right. It is Arcturus III. So if I zoom out of the map, we have Alpha Centauri here and Arcturus is right here, kind of like northeast of Alpha Centauri, New Atlantis. So once you hit Arcturus, you're going to see DerreTech headquarters. It is just orbiting. You're not landing anywhere. And once you travel there, you're going to see this big, huge sphere, which looks pretty cool. I mean, this is something that the game doesn't have. And I'm super impressed that the author made such a thing. If you look at it from the outside, you will just see that it is kind of a sphere with an entrance. You cannot see anything that is inside, but there are actually things that are inside. And I'm going to take you guys there. The thingy, the protuberance here, the hexagon, I think, that you see here, that is the docking port. And I show you guys the inside, all the new stuff, all the new parts that we now have. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. I'm pretty excited to start using some of these parts. And there are a couple of minor glitches. I don't think these robots are supposed to just all be congregated here. I think they're supposed to be stationed in different places, I believe. Not 100% sure. And also, yeah, your companion may kind of get stuck. But once you start moving around and they follow you, they will kind of get out of whatever this is. So we have a showroom here now, and you can see two samples, two builds, just the models of some of the DerreTech builds. So there's one, and there's another one here, which, by the way, you can totally buy them. You do not have to build these two yourself. You're actually able to buy them. Now, we are here. This is the second level. There is a showroom at the bottom, which you can go down using the elevator here. So you have a sales, the docking platform where we are now, and the showroom. Looks like there's going to be maybe other areas in the future, reactor, engineering, executive level, and CEO office. Those, you cannot go to those right now, but I think it might be planned for future. We'll see. So you can use the elevator to come down, or you can just jump from, you know, that platform outside there. And you have now a showroom. And I gotta say, this reminds me of that game. What is it called? That game that is in perpetual alpha state. What is it called? Star Citizen. That's the one. I think it is Star Citizen, right? The one that started as a crowdfunding type of project. And I remember that game has a lot of free events with a showroom where you can see their space ships and things like that. This reminds me a lot of that. So you have two models here that shows this ship in smaller scale. It looks pretty cool. So you have this one. I think this is how the wings are when it is landed. And this is how the wings are when you are actually flying. They are absolutely the same model. And you can buy these two if you want. So there is this is probably another glitch because this whole thing is invisible. I don't see anything. However, you can click on it and you can purchase this one, which is called Bird of Prey. So you can see it. This is the ship. It costs 577,000 and some change. It looks pretty nice. This is the bigger one of the two models. And I don't know why there are two here. Like, if you want, you can buy two. I don't think they are different. Like, I don't see the numbers change. And I don't see any physical difference. But anyway, if you want to buy two for some reason, then you know there's two here. It is a very nice looking ship, which by the way, maybe some of you have already noticed, but there are new parts. There are a few new parts. They are pretty cool. I'm pretty excited for some of those new parts. And we're going to go over those in a moment when we go into the build menu and show you guys the list. So this is one of them. And of course, you can also go in. So if you want to take a look at the inside, let's go inside and let's check it out. So you have this level. All the hubs, I noticed that they're all one by one. So the author did not use any of the vanilla parts or hubs. They just put all one by ones kind of together to each other. By the way, let's take a look at this now since we're already here. So we now have elevators in this. I'm going to show you this module by itself later on, but this is basically the elevator that you can have inside your ship. So there's nothing back here, and you can choose. So this has four different levels. We're on the first one, and you can choose which other floor you want to go. And once you activate it, of course, because it is a Starfield game, you get a loading screen, although it's a pretty quick one. And this, I believe, is the second level, the level with the cockpit. So let's go in. So we have this area, we have this module, this is not new, and we have now this cockpit, or I guess some people will probably correct me and say that this is a bridge, but you know, whatever. So here it is. This is one of them. This is the larger cockpit or bridge, and you have chairs. I don't know if you can sit. It looks like you cannot sit, but it could be because this is a model, not the real thing, so that's why you cannot sit. Yeah, this is just a model, but I think when you build a real one, your companions can sit up there, and that is your captain's chair. And a lot of computers here, same thing on the other side. So it's a pretty nice one. The interior, I do like it. It's a pretty fantastic looking cockpit. All right, so let's go. And I don't think there's anything in particular on the top levels. So, but we can go level 3. Again, I think mostly are just one by ones put together. And same thing here on the top floor. There's a ramp here that kind of, I think it just leads to other hubs. Nothing in particular. So this is how it is for the ship, the model. If you buy them, you can change those hubs to vanilla hubs for things that you want. And we can now go out. And we can take a look at the second one. Hopefully we get more soon. Hopefully the author adds. It looks like there might be more things. So this is the smaller one. And you can see kind of looks like a baby dragon. And this is just the model of the cockpit itself. And you can also buy this one. And I believe here in this invisible place or here. Okay, there we go. So yeah, it's actually called baby dragon. Look at that. And this is the ship that you can buy. So this one, of course, is a little bit cheaper, smaller, at 219,000 and some change. Again, you also have two, but they look identical. I don't think there's any difference. So there you have it. And this is the ship. So, and now, of course, we can go in as well, take a look. So it doesn't have a lot here, a couple of hubs, and then when you go up, we have the cockpit. So this is a much smaller. This is actually, I think it is a definition of a cockpit. So there you have it. All right. So now let's go back up and I'll show you how you can actually buy parts and things like that. Because one change that I don't like. Okay. So we're going to the top floor, the sales. And one thing that I don't like about this change is that all the parts from DerreTech, now they only show up here. I even have the mod that is called All Parts Unlocked, so you can have all your parts at your landing bay when you're building. Well, this one no longer shows up after the update. So yeah, it is one of those things that I'm not a big fan of, especially structural parts. When you're building a ship, you kind of want to be able to play around with those, right? To see how it looks. So I do wish the author would allow at least the structural parts to be able to show up everywhere. So anyway, so we are here in the sales level. I have a feeling that all those robots that are kind of stuck up there, they're probably supposed to show up on this square so that when you interact with them, they are the vendors. So this one, this specialist, you can grab all the class A parts. So all the A parts will show up with this invisible vendor. I would just go to the one at the top where it shows you all the parts. So there's probably no need to play with the vendors below. So this one will show you all the C class ship parts. So I would just go up to the top, and there is this vendor in this platform here, the master ship, right, where it will give you all the modules. Now let's take a look at this one, since it gives you all the modules. I do want to point out only third-party mod parts seem to show up here. Like, for example, DerreTech, of course, Matilija. Then we have also, I think, Avontech and Tiger. The vanilla parts do not show up here. Maybe just a few here and there. For some reason, Vanguard, Recon, Graph Drive, this one shows up here. So keep that in mind. Now let's take a look at some of the new things. So I think these engines are new. I don't recall having seen these engines from DerreTech before. So there's a kind of a smaller one, and then there's a larger one, an A class and a C class. And this is one of the engines. It looks pretty cool. I'm gonna try to see if I can use this somewhere in a build in the future. So that is one of the new parts. We also have this docker. This docker looks also new. I don't remember seeing that before. It's a pretty cool docker. It looks pretty nice. You can flip it to go to the top or to the bottom. So top and bottom, depending on where you want it. And then there is also a new DerreTech landing bay. So this is a pretty sleek looking landing bay. The entrance is at the top, not at the back. But it looks very nice. It looks very sleek. So I'll probably be using this one somewhere in a build in the future. Oh, and there's also this new weapon that looks really badass. There's this DerreTech Neo Howitzer. And this one has a max power of 6. So you can only have 2. Good fire rate, good distance. And it looks really sick. This looks really nice. I definitely like it. And then we have some new structure parts. For example, this one, the DerreTech sensor array. So this is a new part, something that looks pretty nice that you can put underneath your ship to give it a little bit more flair. It does not flip or anything. This is it. This is what you get. Then we also have new wings. So we have these ones. These are new wings. It's kind of nice that you can have it in different orientations. So that's kind of nice if you prefer, you know, different orientation, you can flip them however. So those are new. Then there's also this one that's also new. It looks like a wing, but you can mount weapons on it. So again, you can also flip it to one side or the other. There is this new fender, and I think this is also a new wing. I remember DerreTech has a large wing, which is the previous wing that we always have. This one, the humongous one. And now you also have this slightly smaller wing that I think you can also mount a weapon there. So those are new wings. This is another part that I'm really excited about. It goes at the back. So many times I built a ship where I didn't know how to hide the back or how to make it look nice. And finally, we have a part that can go at the back of the ship to make it look, you know, a little bit nicer, more aggressive, things like that. So there is this one part here. This is the DerreTech tail. Looks fantastic. And there is also an equipment plate that goes on the side. And I gotta say, this equipment plate looks so much nicer than the default one that we have, the vanilla one. This looks very beautiful. I think this is fantastic. And after that, I think everything is about the same. The only other new parts are in the hubs category. So we have stairs, right? We have the ramps, and now we have elevators. There is two versions. There's the one with 3 levels, or if you want, there's the one with 4 levels. I gotta say, I still prefer the stairs, I think. Mostly because the elevator has the, loading screen animation. So yeah. And by the way, so you have another showroom here at the top. I don't think the floor is supposed to be invisible. I believe there is a glass here. It's just so clean that it looks like there is nothing. But I believe it's a glass floor that shows you the cockpit, the two cockpits. It shows you some of the one-by-one hubs that you can go in. There's also the neck, the one that goes from one to two. So that's the neck. Then you also have the ramps that leads into stairs. And by the way, this thing, this platform here, this is not part of the mod. Like, I think this was just put in here for demonstration for this, nothing else. And then at the back here, this is the elevator. This is the one with four levels. So you have, you know, the levels. That is the update from DerreTech. The only thing I really hope the author will reconsider is to allow the structural parts to be able to show up everywhere, just to make shipbuilding easier. And by the way, so you have a few more models of some of their items and things like that. One thing that I didn't know is that you could put these parts, like a smaller parts, inside the structure. I just found out now, right now, that I'm looking at these. I didn't know you could put those things inside. There's another vendor here that says Glass Doctor that currently, I don't think it does anything. Like, maybe somebody knows, because I go in, it says Glass Doctor, but I don't have actually any of the parts showing up. No DerreTech part shows up here. I feel like it's maybe something, a repair thing, or maybe something for the future. I don't know. Something related to the cockpits and bridges. I don't know. So there you have it. Just a quick video. Just wanted to give you guys an update on this. I have a big ship build coming up. I'll try to get that video out as soon as possible. I just need to finish decorating the interior and the video will be up. It is using DerreTech parts, Matilija parts, and also AvonTech. Like, I'm using all three mods. So it's going to look pretty epic. It's going to be huge. So stay tuned for that. And if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe, help support my channel. Other than that, thank you all for watching, enjoy the game, have fun, and I see you all in the next video.